Friends of Princess Park. The park's been a wonderful refuge for people over the last year during COVID. So many people have been in the park just walking, running, resting, reflecting. It's been wonderful. And for me, I've enjoyed doing my solitary park runs. I think I've done about 100. Looking at the lake birds, especially the swans, and seeing the cygnet fly to a new place. The heron catching fish. The parakeets, when they roost at night, they make such a noise, and I really want to know what they're saying. I've been planting trees and looking after trees with fop, and that has been lovely, and especially enjoyed lying in a pile of smouldering wood chip with the smell of forests. I just wanted to lie there forever.
Here I am under my favourite home oak tree in Princess Park, doing one of my favourite things. Some bit of Tai Chi and also a little bit of COVID safe socialising one-to-one with a person filming this. Princess Park has just been a wonderful place for so many of us in this during these difficult times, and appreciate it, enjoy it, love it. What more can I say?
Hi, I'm Colin. I'm a friend of the Friends of Princes Park. My wife Ingrid is very active, and I get dragged in to do all sorts of interesting things to help out with the friends. And at the moment, we've been putting together some posters which are going up in the park to try to discourage people from feeding bread to the birds, because it can actually be quite harmful to them. And I think most people are fine about that, but actually they don't know, and once they know, then they start looking to use grain, to throw grains and oats and some fruit to the birds, which is much better for them.
Hi, my name is Daniel Tarbuck, and this is Princess Park. And this is a place where we come to smile, feel good, because this is carbon, hydrogen, oxygen that we actually come from. And I love coming to the park and spending lots of time in here. And it rejuvenates me, it makes me feel good and at peace with the world I live in. And these are some of the roses that we all planted, all the volunteer groups that come to the park. And we put lots of time in here. We have lots of smiles and share experience, share stories. Sometimes we share drinks and biscuits and cake when we're not in COVID. But we uplift each other and we uplift the park. And there's no stress, there's no commotion. It's just nice and relaxed. And everyone gets involved and does as little or as much as you want. And it's just very therapeutic. It shows people who love and enjoy the park, and you don't come here for anything else. It's just an outlet where there's no stress put on you, and it's a really nice thing to do. It's plenty of fresh air, plenty of good company, plenty of lovely, beautiful trees and flowers to look at. A great place to be. I recommend it to anyone.
Hiya, my name is Wes. I do football coaching with my friends over there.
Hi, my name's Shafi, I'm a football coach in Liverpool.
And we enjoy Princess Park, so we come here on a nice sunny Sunday. Lovely fresh air, enjoy the environment, and do some football coaching ourselves, keep ourselves fit. And lovely evening view.
Find that the surface is good over here compared to a lot of other parks in Liverpool. So today is the first day we actually trained here, but obviously we visit this park every day. So and we don't think we're going to be moving from here now.
Yeah, and we'll do a quick demonstration. So Shafi, if you want to put the ball in the air. Yeah, Shafi, go.
Hi, I'm Minx, and I've lived by Prince's Park now for 40 years. One of the lovely things about living here is you can come and walk in the park after you've been to work, or late at night if you need to have a bit of air. And it's always gorgeous to come and see the blossoms coming out and look at the lovely filigree trees against a blue sky with the sun in your eyes. And the sound of kids playing, and rabbit, rabbit. Some of the trees in Prince's Park are really old, and I think this must be one of the oldest. I don't know how old it is. I've been told it's 200 years old. There's something very beautiful about old trees, and just touching them, you feel a connection to Earth and how long they've been here. Which is part of the joy of trees and parkland, I think.
Hi, I'm Kit Hoy. I'm a friend of Prince's Park, and I love running in the park in the sun, and spring is glorious.
Hi, my name is Hakan. We come in this park with my dog every day.
Hi, I'm Robert. I'm a friend of Prince's Park, and I'm here to take this stump of a tree. Sadly, it's died. It was a sweet chestnut, died of some fungal disease, and we're going to replace it with a nice English oak. There aren't actually very many English oaks in Prince's Park, so we're going to have a nice English oak.
Amazing.
Okay, stop. Stop. Brilliant, thank you.
My name is Tracey and I live next to the park. I'm a friend of Prince's Park for about 15 years, and I've actually planted quite a lot of the trees that are here, and I've put the metal fences around them, then we've mulched them and we've even pruned them